Today we're going to talk about how to install a switch and stop on the Bigtree Tech GTR version 1.0. Now, just so you know, there's multiple types of switch and stops. The one over on the right over here uses only two wires. So it's going to use the signal and the ground wire on the end stop, whereas the other one has circuitry on it that smooths out the actual end stop. So I'm going to show you a little bit more detail on that one. So I'm going to zoom in, and as you can see right here, I put three colors on there, being green, black, and red. Those correspond to the pins underneath, and those are for green being signal, black being ground, and red being voltage. So on the right hand side over here, I have one set up where you can see the actual cabling and how it's set up. So I'm going to show you how to attach this in just a second, but we got to look over on the browser for a moment to see what it looks like. So I'm going to bring up the browser, as you can see right here, and they have a bunch of different steppers, or excuse me, end stops in here for switching. And the first row says E0, 1, and 2. That means that they're used probably for filament runout. Then below it we have negative X, Y, and Z, and those will be our end stops. So it's X minimum, so you have your voltage, ground, and signal. Then you have your Y, which is exactly the same, and so on and so forth between all of these. Now these might be reserved for some other functionality yet to be determined. So we're not going to worry about that at the moment. So we're going to go back to our workbench over here, and I'm going to connect up the first end stop, and this one will be for the one that has circuitry on it. So you can see there's three wires. So we're going to go to the X minimum, which is right over here, and we're going to place it down like so. So you can see what the wiring is and how it's connected. Then we're gonna do the Z as well. Now the Z's gonna be different because of the red and black wires, so we have to do ground and signal. So it's gonna be the bottom two pins, and it's gonna look like that. So the next thing that we need to do is actually prepare this to load the firmware. So in order to do that, I need to pop out the drive. Once the drive's out, I'm gonna insert it into my converter over here so I can use it on my computer. And what I'll do is I'll place an Amazon affiliate link in the description so you can find this, as well as the GTR board. And just so you know, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do these tutorials, but people do tip to ask for certain tutorials, so I do prioritize those if they in fact need those right away. So some of the things that we have to look at on here, before we do anything further, I'm going to pre-prep this so that you can actually see what's going on. So I'm going to pop out the actual jumper and move it over here. That'll allow us to power through the USB rather than direct power. But when you're actually using the board, this needs to be on these two jumpers over here. But for now, we're just testing the end stop, so I'm going to place them right there. So let's move over to the computer and see if we can look in VS Code to see how to set this up. So inside VS Code, we're going to have to load the actual software. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do that. So we're going to go over here and we're going to say Explorer. Then we're going to go to the open folder, then our downloads folder, where we have our unzipped Marlin 2.0. So we're going to open that up. Then we need to open up the second one. Then we're going to say select folder. Inside here, we're going to then click on the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to search on GTR underscore V1, which will bring us to our board type. So I'm going to highlight that and I'm actually going to copy it. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to minimize core and source and go to configuration.h. Here I'm going to search on motherboard, and I'm going to highlight the ramps board because we're not using that, and paste ours are over it. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the serial port and change that to -1 so we can communicate with our actual board. So let me fix that real quick. Then we're going to scroll down and find NSTOP. So we're going to search on NSTOP. And as you can see, it's got three NSTOPs enabled right here for our X minimum, our Y minimum, and our Z minimum. But further on down, we have actual circuitry that we can enable, being the circuitry on the NSTOP, if we wanted to smooth out the NSTOP pull-ups. That would be the resistors and capacitors on the second NSTOP I showed you. Now, there's a high level and a low level for this, meaning a pull-up and a pull-down. For now, we're going to ignore that because it's not really relevant anymore. But we do have to pay attention here. So our end stops, the logic may be inverted, which one of them is. And that would be the one with all the circuitry on it. So I'm going to change the false to a true. That way we can deal with that when it comes up and it'll be the correct entry. But if you do have an issue where it says triggered when it shouldn't, you can always change your true to a false or your false to a true depending upon the configuration. So I may get it wrong, but at least you now know how to change it to the correct setting. So next we need to go to platformio.ini, and inside here there's a default environment which is for the Mega 2560, but we need to set it for the GTR. So we're going to do a search on GTR underscore V1, and that'll bring us to our configuration right here. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to go back up to the top and paste it over where the Mega 2560 is. Now that that's all set, we're going to do a clean, which is this little garbage can over here so that we can clean out the previous build in case there's a change. And then we're going to do a build with the checkbox. So I'm going to click on this checkbox and it will begin to build our build. Now this may take upwards of 25 seconds to build on this computer. On other computers, it may take longer, but keep that in mind because it does vary computer to computer. Once this is finished, though, we're going to actually check to see over here what our current firmware is. Right now it says firmware.cur. That was the last one that loaded on our board that we have loaded in the thumb drive right now. But let's go back and check on ours right now. So it's completed. So in order to find it, we have to go to the .pio folder, then the BigTree Tech GTR folder, right click and reveal and explorer. Then what we'll do is, now that we can see it in the explorer, we're going to go into the GTR folder. We're then going to right click on firmware.bin and we're going to send it to our D drive. Now you can confirm that by clicking on your D drive and see that firmware.bin for the binary is there. Once it loads, it will be renamed to firmware.cur, or something may have occurred. So now that that's done, I'm going to go back over to the workbench so you can see what I'm talking about. So I'm going to pop out the drive. I'm then going to extract the drive out right here. And I'm going to insert it into the actual SD card holder. Then I'm going to power this. Remember, I did move the jumper over so that it can power via USB. And you'll see a flashing light down here, which means the firmware is loading. So the next thing we want to do is actually go over to Pronterface. So inside Pronterface, what we're going to see is that it's COM port 1. So we've got a problem. We need to figure out what the COM port is. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go to Device Manager. And I'm going to open that up. And inside Device Manager, I'm going to examine the ports. So port 14 appears to be our port. So I'm going to close this down. Now I'm going to change the COM port to number 14. Then I'm going to connect, and as you can see, it says connecting. Printer is now online over here. So now we can actually check the end stops. So to check these, what we're going to do is we're going to type the G code M119 and press enter. And as you can see, both of these say open, and the Z min says that it is triggered. That means it's not connected right now, as you can see on the board. So let's go to the first end stop, being our X end stop, and trigger it with our finger. So I'm going to trigger this by holding it down. You probably can see it a little bit better now. Now I'm going to do the send. Let me just hold this better. And you can see it's triggered. Now I'm going to release it and send again. And now it says open. So let's try the other one. Now it says triggered. Now let's let it go. And now it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.